Rivalry Saturday continues here on ESPN. You're looking at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena, California. For just a few moments, the 62nd meeting between the Trojans of Southern California and the Bruins of UCLA.
As we said, this is the 62nd meeting between these two schools, and here are the numbers. SC leads it 34-20, and there have been seven ties. Last year, the Bruins won it by three, 24-21. The last game at the Rose Bowl, USC won it 45-42, the highest scoring game, in fact, in the entire history of this series. Here's a look at Conway. Curtis, 63, a USC record as far as kickoff returns. Merrill kicks it off, and we are underway. Very short kick, and it will come down to a blocking back at the 34-yard line. For the Trojans in this one this afternoon, Rob Johnson at quarterback has to be careful of the turnover. We'll see how he reacts to the big game situation today. He's got a couple of receivers that are just burners, Conway and Morton. Conway is the big play guy, and up front, an offensive line that has been on the mend because of injury. Chrisman, the best of the healthy starters. And a pass on first down is tipped and almost intercepted of the homestanding UCLA club. Mike Chilinski, former pitcher in high school, they beefed him up to 265, plays with a cast on his hand. The linebackers, very good and active. Jameer Miller, keep an eye on him. And in the secondary, Carlton Gray, 16 career interceptions for him. Very good one. Wow, the stick by Othello Henderson, allowing 286 yards of ball game. Third down, the line to make the 45. From a shotgun, has him open over the middle, throws it complete. That's Travis Hanna. 25-second clock, down to one, gets it away. Gonna go deep this time. It is incomplete. Hold its two tailbacks. Estes Creighton, 23, and Deion Strother, number 25. Passing on second down, though, right over the middle. Yanni Jackson, the tight end, still on his feet and will be tackled at the UCLA 46.
That's a concern of theirs.
Conway in motion. And that's who he's looking for. Nope, he's going to throw underneath. And is it caught? They say yes. Johnny Morton scooped it up. Creighton the ball carrier. To the left side, and he'll take it to the 35. Creighton gets a block and a good second effort. He's inside the 30 to the 28, along with Mike Mooney, the two fullbacks, along with Creighton. Power eye set to the short side of the field. And on a quick count, it's Creighton, and it slides off one tackler. And from where the linesman to the near side... Draw play. This is Creighton. Nothing inside. Takes it outside. And he will have three, now 4 yards. Ollie, one of the guys that really hurt them by not being there. He also was an inside backer. Straight ahead with the fullback. Mooney powers his way to the 19-yard line. And you could see how tight the splits are for the offensive line on that last play. And the same, if not tighter, on this third down. Creighton, boy, he gets belted at the line of scrimmage. That is O'Quinn, and I don't believe he picked up the first down. Ball will be placed down at the 26-yard line, a 36-yard attempt. Plenty of distance. It is a knuckleball, but it's good.
Wait, Will,
so, it's a Necro 3. Take a timeout. 8:57 left opening quarter. 3-0 Trojans. Davis, 3 yards deep. And John Barnes, the senior from Mission Viejo. Kevin Williams gets the started tailback and has a gain close to 10 yards for the UCLA Bruins tonight. Khalif Carter, and keep in mind, he is the only healthy fullback that the Bruins have. Everybody else are tailbacks. Sean LaChapelle, he's missed 4 games because of injuries. It is a rib injury. They hope that he's close to 100% tonight. And in the offensive front, Craig Nowitzki, a junior out of Woodbridge, Virginia. Very versatile. He can play guard or tackle, and this year he's had to do both. Short drop, looking pass, off the hands. Defensively for the Trojans, David Webb, only 225 pounds, but he's very quick. Makes it tough on an offensive tackle with his quickness. The linebackers, they're good ones and active. Willie McGinnis, 16 tackles for losses this year for SC. And in the secondary, the brains back there, Stephon Pace, Duarte, California. He's the quarterback and calls the signals. Williams again puts a head down, and he will cross the 30 and have the first down. Leads the team at that number with 16 tackles, four losses. Pass is complete. That's Kevin Jordan, a redshirt freshman. Kevin Williams. Not much there, and he'll slide back to the right. And check the stickers on my luggage. Pitch goes to Williams, trying to secure the football, and that is a great play by Mike Salmon and other little injuries this year. Third down, the line to make the 47.
A nice draw down for UCLA here.
Barnes steps up, delivers the pass, has it complete at the 50. J.J. Stokes, and the ball is loose, and UCLA recovers, and with that, that will be enough for the first down. But the Bruins keep the drive alive. Senior from Spring, Texas, Kevin Williams again on the carry. You can see the linebackers coming on the blitz. Good protection. Ball is delivered right on time, and it's Rick Daly. He's a senior. Great look at the Rose Bowl Stadium, and this is the 62nd matchup between SC and UCLA. Not much for Kevin Williams this time. The 11th play of the drive coming up. 3-0. SC leads it. From the outside, the ball is tipped and falls harmlessly. It's going to be against SC.
One ball. Let's go, foul. Defense. 15 yards.
On and off the major penalty. Williams. 5-10. Counting off at 6 points. Touchdown, UCLA. Take a break. 4:12 left in this opening quarter. Our new score, UCLA 7, SC 3. And that's how we stand at 7-3. And they will not kick it off to the speedster. Curtis Conway. Ball is loose, and UCLA has recovered inside the 35-yard line.
Ron, that's why you like to have your up people. Fair catch. Follow the block of Craig Nowitzki, number 71, for the touchdown.
Williams again tries to cut it up, but it's a fine defensive play on the outside. And then a personal foul, roughing the passer, and then they scored immediately the 18-yard run. Pressure from the outside, and that pass thrown. You could see how well he runs. Darren Washington, not much there, and all of a sudden, you see his numbers when he is outside the 40 range, 3-7. Got plenty of distance on this one, though, and he's good. Let's take a break. 2:47 left in the opening quarter. The Bruins, 10-3. Don't want Conway to handle the ball. That ball is loose and now picked up at the 30-yard line, and it's Conway. And he will take it to the 38, now the 39-yard line. Short drop and a quick out pass. He They want to get it to Conway, and they do. Breaks off one tackle, and he'll take it for 8 yards. It's Creighton who will take it inside the 45. Take to Strother, and he rolls the pocket. In the flat, and he has it complete this time to him. And he is out of bounds. To throw, now throws it back to the quarterback, and Johnson has it, and you can see the blockers in front. Touchdown, Southern Cal. Ford with the extra point attempt, and he's good.
Southern Cal is a quarterback. Just going to step back. But now watch Carlton Green, number three, beat the block. He's got the tackle. Curtis Conway just enough arm to get the ball back to Rob Johnson, number 11. Now he gets a lot of help from the offensive line to get in the end zone for the touchdown.
Back, nothing at the line of scrimmage, and that's because McGinnis is there to. Looks, has the pass to Jordan, and he is short of the 25. And now here comes a flag from deep downfield.
Good ball, off the run, push the foul, offense.
Craig Nowitzki, number 71, with a late hit.
Gonna go up on top. And tipped. That is a nice defensive play by Henry. Trager's kick, and it's off the side of his foot. You can see it for a left footer is hooking back in, and it is touched by the Bruins just around midfield. 38 yards on the kick, and that is the end of the first quarter. We are tied. Let's take a break. Let's see if they calm down and play some defense here in this second quarter. Johnson, as the flag goes down, had a man open. Would have been a tough completion.
Field maybe turns up field too quick.
For a loss at the 41-yard line. So with the loss on top of the penalty, it is second down and 19 for the Trojans. Good protection that time, and dropped by Conway. A pair of threes. Pressure is on. Pass is almost intercepted, and for the second time in the ball game. Chappelle on the run, gets away from it, and is still loose, touched by SC. Down inside the 10.
Should come back up the field here, where Southern Cal touched it at.
On that play.
Billy!
Kevin Williams breaks it open across the 37 to the 38-yard line from the Rose Bowl in Pasadena, California. There you see our situation. Excellent ball game so far. Being grabbed and knocked out of bounds, and that's McGinnis. A second down, and the line to make is just out across the 48. Swing pass. He wanted Darren Washington.
Well, you know, from all I know right now is that it's likely that I'm going to start. John's going to try to throw before the game, but he's had some problems with it. So if he can't go, then I'm going to start.
Pressure is on, and Barnes will be sacked. That's Terry McDaniel. Jager's kick. Late what Mike said, is going to come out of bounds.
Yeah, they're going to be all right.
Good luck in your start tomorrow. Ron.
Thanks, Adrian, and Tommy, thanks to you. A lot of players come back for this one. It shows how big the game is. As Creighton tries to turn the corner, and he turns nothing into a three-yard gain. On the shotgun, steps up, pass is incomplete. This time, numbers on Johnson so far. He's 5 of 10, 43 yards, and he has missed his last three. Left alone, oh my goodness. And UCLA got away with an error there. Even when the ball was delivered, that could have even been offensive pass interference.
Very easily could have been called.
Yeah, either one of those two penalties, but it was not. They set the screen. It is caught and Strother get behind the line of scrimmage.
Picking off, looks like to a pass because his tailback has moved up the block.
UCLA fakes the blitz, then they stay at home. And a pass to the near sideline. Has it complete? That's Joel Scott. Third down. They need the 38-yard line. Rob Johnson deep down the middle. And incomplete as Morton. And a loss of four games by LaChapelle, but they're using him on kick returns, Mike.
Last game, a senior. He's going to try everything he can to help him win this game.
Out to the 17, so let's take a break. Alexander and a tailback, sophomore out of Hawthorne. Remember, we kick this off at 4:30 West Coast time, so we will have both afternoon and evening as it is now getting dark here at the Rose Bowl. From the shotgun, they go with the draw play. Big opening for Washington, and he is across the 45 to the 47-yard line. Low. LaChapelle couldn't do much with that one. The reverse, Jordan. SC not fooled at all, and that's Jason Seahorn. A clip against UCLA. At the 43, because he's wearing the protection on his ribs, the flak jacket. Third and long, looking, and it is caught. J.J. Stokes, and he'll walk in. 57 yards.
How about John Barnes? What a pass. What a catch by J.J. Stokes.
Extra point attempt is up and good. And watch the gamble on defense. Stokes will take it away. And he will make the catch right there and take it the distance. Bruins, 17-10. The dangerous one. And they have put him almost in a freelance position. He's going to come over and try to take this one, and he will at the 26. He stopped at the 33. I hope we get to see Baselli tonight. He has had an injury, and whether we'll get to see him, they were going to try to play. Badly sprained ankle. Creighton. Gets by one tackler, then being shoved back short of the 40-yard line. That's Othella Henderson. Darren Washington, the tailback, number 30, that you saw in that last series, also from Cleveland. Pitch the sweep, that's Creighton, and he'll have the first down. And a surprise finish for the Jayhawks. They stumbled coming home. It's Bender in the ball game, and the senior from Burbank. Look, he was a really good pitcher in high school, wasn't he?
Very, very solid pitcher, and a great linebacker.
Creighton turns the corner, down the sideline, and will be knocked out of bounds inside the 20 at the 18. Marvin Goodwin got it. Whoever has the football is headed toward the end zone. Creighton inside this time, and it's 47, Carrick of Plan, the junior out of West Lake Village. The injured Bruce Walker. It's Creighton. Hit as he tries to run it into the boundary, and then wow, the UCLA defense. Pressure was on, and Johnson will run at the five, and still don't have a signal, and they will say out of bounds. Just short of the goal line, Othella Henderson. Straight ahead, and Johnson's not going to have it. No signal. And for the drive. Touchdown, USC. Quarterback is 6'4", 210. I guess you're just wedging behind those huge offensive linemen. And Cole Ford with the extra point attempt, and he's got it. So let's take a break. 3:22 left until halftime, and again, we are tied. This time, it's 17. From the 5-yard line, this is Davis. And he will take it to the 22-yard line. At the 32, and La Chapelle will take it out to the 37-yard line.
Well, they should, the way he's played.
You see him pull the guards, but a nice defensive play, and Salmon. Pressure was on. He will try to step up, and Barnes will be caught. Brian Williams. Tripped up, and he is short of the first down by about 8 or 9 yards.
To the right, he knows it's going to the right.
That's where it goes. Not a good kick, not very far. It's Cole Ford. His longest field goal of the year is 41 yards, which by today's standards is not extremely long. They're going to move the ball quite a distance to get in that way. Pressure from behind, still able to get it away, and it is still almost caught by Curtis Conway. He's flat on his back.
Down the field to try to get in field goal range.
Rob Johnson is also looking at 6 defensive backs on this play. Ball is loose, and he does the only smart thing, and rather than try to pick it up, 3 wide receivers come to the bottom of your screen. Pressure is on. He has to throw it short, and it's an incomplete pass, and now good coverage kick, and La Chapelle will run away from it. Terry Donahue playing the percentages here as the ball goes out of bounds with 1 second. And the running play will go for a couple, and we are at halftime. The Delta Fawcett Report coming up after this intermission. We are at halftime, UCLA 17 and Southern California 17. Come down to Ricky Davis, and he will let it go into the end zone, and the Bruins short drop and pass to La Chapelle, and he'll take it out to the 22-yard line. Williams runs into his own man, tries to get to the outside, and by golly, he has the speed to at least lose only a couple. Washington and Davis, the setbacks, third down, and they need the 30-yard line. Retreated in making the reception, and now let's see where La Chapelle will be given forward progress. Looking at Curtis Conway, and Conway has caused problems tonight just by being there. Hanging spiral, he'll get an opportunity here. And good coverage for the Bruins to stop him at the 33. And he is now 1 yard away from Flipper Anderson and going into the record books. Big opening to the fullback, Mike Mooney. And he will take it across the 50-yard line.
weaves his way for 5, 6, and 7 yards. Pitch to Creighton. Turns the corner. Boy, he gets stung at the 40-yard line, but he'll have the first down. Morton to the top. Short drop, and that's who it's to. Conway squeezes by one tackle. That was Carlton Gray.
He had 11 interceptions last year. Just people aren't throwing in his vicinity this year.
And could have had two more tonight. Knocked down hard at the line of scrimmage. That's Miller who gets him. It's very calm here at the Rose Bowl tonight, though. Pitch to Creighton. Trouble in the backfield. He will be knocked down for a loss. Donnie Edwards has been big. To kick. Very high. Good coverage kick. Fair catch is called for and is made. So let's take a break. Running play. Jeff Cox steps up into the hole at the line of scrimmage. Wild and crazy guys who have worn that number. Williams on the delay, and there you see Cox again, number 35. Six have started on or inside their 20. Field position has not been in their favor tonight. And the shotgun puts some air under it. LaChapelle has got it. Look, they're going to say he trapped it against the ground.
Sean LaChapelle with his hands outstretched. The ball's right there. Just couldn't hold on to it. Good coverage by Jason Seahorn side into the UCLA bench.
And that ball is blocked into the end zone and touchdown Southern California. Ramirez. Now we're going to have to get a check. They don't have names and they have duplicate numbers. Either Hector or Ramirez. Goal forward with the extra point attempt, and it's up and good.
Looked like UCLA busted their punt coverage.
24-17, SC on top. Ramirez with the block. Luisi with the recovery for the touchdown. This is Lawrence.
Line.
We never even got a chance to see him.
Williams breaks it big, still on his feet, caught from behind by McGinnis, but not until he's at the 50-yard line. Pressure is on, gets away, and the pass is tipped. That is a nice defensive play by Seahorn.
Here's where they force the quarterback to beat you.
From the outside immediately. Pass is tipped. And an opportunity for Shannon Jones. They need the 41 and a half yard line. Pass thrown short. Slinger a little quicker getting this one away. Go into the end zone. So let's take a break. Keaton Hall, the Bruins with a great come from behind win last night. With a mix up in the play call here, I doubt seriously that they would have had Rob Johnson following his running backs. They need to make and put names on jerseys, football and basketball. Very simple. He had duplicate numbers, and that's the reason for the confusion. Coaches, a good one you were just taking a look at, needs to play well tonight for them to have a successful effort. Flags go down. So that'll be called a false start. Creighton. He had a stand close to the 30-yard line. He'll be stopped there. But fullback open, and he'll take it to the 34. That's Miller again. In the they bring him back in for the Florida State middle screen. Takes it close to midfield, and he's all the way to the 48-yard line. Carlton Gray finally makes the stop.
Your odds aren't very good.
Creighton over the right side and over midfield to the 46-yard line. They're having to play without Tony Boselli, their academic lineman, all academic, I should say. Creighton gets the pitch, turns the corner, and you can see he is beyond the sticks for the first down. Jameer Miller is there to make the stop.
It hurt all year.
Johnson sets the throw, and that's going to be over the head of Johnny Morton. Morton did have the one catch in the first half, good for only 8 yards. Esther Creighton breaks a tackle, has 5 yards, 6, 7, and 8, and he is close to the first down.
They're all close.
Yeah, I saw him shaking hands with Sherbert. Big opening, 15, 10, 5, touchdown, Creighton from 32 yards away. Kick is good, so let's take a timeout. 2:43 left in this third period. Second half has been all Trojans. And has really taken command. Of the best players in a doubleheader next Saturday. And a report on Marshall Faulk here in just a moment as he was injured in their ball game today. Play action, ball is caught wide open, Rick Bailey, and the tight end at the 35-yard line, and what a fake by the running back. Did they ever? It's a gain of 45. Kevin Williams hit behind the line of scrimmage, Maya Kins. His status for Saturday's game with Miami is questionable.
Comes the blitz.
Well, you're right. Everybody. And he's going to be sacked. Ball is loose, and the official says nope, it is down at the 45. The third and 10. Trojans fake blitz. They stay at home. Pass is overthrown, and I'm telling you, La Chapelle. Good high coverage kick, and this one at the 2, and it takes an SC bounce. Pitch goes to Creighton. On the outside, going to be bumped out of bounds. That's Othella Henderson from the sideline. Thanks, Adrian. Creighton breaks off a tackle at the line of scrimmage, and that is the end of the third quarter, so let's take a timeout. 31-17, USC on top. Bruins need a break run here, a turnover, and need something good to happen to them. It has not been that way in the second half so far.
They need a big play on defense.
Here comes the blitz. All out pass is well underthrown. And it came very close to getting the third. Stonehouse gets it away. End over end, but it's high. And La Chapelle runs away from it. And this is going to be big for SC as it goes all the way down to the 31-yard line. That's a 45-yard punt. Southern Cal, safety blitz. Pass is just overthrown. To the 45-yard line, pass to the tight end.
Well, the Southern Cal defense just went to the package and putting pressure on John Barnes.
Short drop and a quick out pass, La Chapelle. There's your record. Down to the 49-yard line, and here comes a late flag in.
See the catch? There's the face mask by Jason Seahorn, number 18.
Daly, and the tight end pushed out of bounds at the 27. He's coming into the lineup, the redshirt freshman out of Beltsville, Maryland, number 4. They go with the draw play, and Webb made the tackle, and he guessed right. Chappelle on the sideline being attended to. Third down, and they go. No running play. Pass. wide open, J.J. Stokes, touchdown, UCLA. What a fake.
Well, Jason Oliver bought into the fake. It's that same pass fake that John Barnes was successful in earlier.
Next point attempt is up and good. Perez knocks it home, and we have a new ball game. 7 points is our margin now.
Jason Oliver, number four. Man coverage just slips and falls, and then that's all J.J. Stokes needs. To Jason Oliver, now coaches the secondary here at Southern Cal.
And UCLA goes with the pooch kick. Conway will get it anyway, and he will take it across the 40 to the 43-yard line.
I really think Texas will play Texas A&M tight.
Go with the running play. This is Bender. And he will be stopped after a gain of only one. UCLA wants a winning record. And for the Trojans, they want a seventh victory and maybe the Fiesta Bowl. There's Johnny Morton. Second catch by him tonight. And straight ahead with the quarterback sneak. It'll be a Trojan first down.
No, you just, that shows how much respect they have for Curtis Conley.
The moment had a big opening, then it closed up. You can see the play clock. If Creighton gets the pitch, he'll be ridden down by O'Quinn. Creighton popped as he comes across the 35. Ball is loose. Southern Cal has recovered as Rod Johnson got on it.
Oh.
Rose is back deep. And he tries to pooch this one. At the five and chipped back into the field of play. Did he get it? No, they have beanbagged the end zone. It's a touchback. Position has been tough for them all night. Ball is thrown and has it complete at the 32 to Stokes.
A good mix. They've had success with the draw on the run.
Good touch on that one again. It's Stokes. Breaks it big up the middle. Still on his feet at the 10 and down to the 7-yard line. And they are jumping across the way in Bruin land.
Caught him on the same blitz.
Well, he's a good athlete. Williams to the right side. Cuts it up at the five. What a move he put on the man on the outside. Williams at the one. That'll be it. It has belonged to the Bruins, tied again, this time at 31. Rolls the pocket, over the middle, tip, knockdown, Henderson making the play on Wallace. On second down, steps up, delivers deep over the middle, it is tipped, and because of the big hit, not sure he could have held on because of Henderson's blow anyway. Ball is caught by Conway. The pressure is on, and that's who they go to.
Big play for USC.
The clock, you see, that's all the time remaining in the ballgame. Fullback, Bender. Bruce Walker will step up to make the hit on him.
Washington State's not in the bowl game. I've read all week that they may not be. It would be an injustice.
Pressure is on, and it's Jameer Miller who comes across with the sack. And
get one-on-one on the other side with Johnny Morton, number 80.
5 minutes left, tied at 31. They bring the inside linebackers. Pressure is on from the middle, and he rushes out of the pocket. And Johnson will be out of bounds about 9 yards shy of the first down. This is a very nice kick right here. Bounding and going to be downed at the 2-yard line. So let's take a break. And the band, of course, they have to stop playing at the snap of the ball, but they're making a lot of noise. Kevin Williams will take it straight ahead.
Hit that rip section.
J.J. Stokes has been the man who has replaced him, who scored a touchdown. And here's a draw play. Number 20, Kevin Williams, taking it out to close to the 10-yard line.
Pulling for a defensive stop while the UCLA fans are pulling for a first down.
Barnes lifts the pass. Oh, he's got Stokes wide open. Cuts back at the 15. To make it a 7-point lead, and he does.
I think UCLA athletic department will make sure that John Barnes never has to sneak in to another UCLA football team. What a pass by John Barnes. The blitz is on. J.J. Stokes beats Gerald Henry, number 26, but now does a nice job of weaving to try to stay away from being tackled by Gerald Henry. Just keeps running away from him. Tries to stiff arm. Now stops. Now gets some pressure from backside Jason Oliver, but he is committed to getting in that end zone.
So long, then his next program dissolved their football program, and here he is. Kick off to the 18. Conway to the 30-yard line. When you talk about a dream.
He's living it tonight. For every walk-on in America, he is making something possible for all of you.
Johnson will run for the sideline, delivers the pass, and he was very close to being across the line of scrimmage.
As long as he has number 80 Morton and number 3 Curtis Conley, he's not out of this game yet.
No, I don't mean to suggest that he
is. No, I don't.
Here comes the outside blitz. Pass over the middle. It is tipped at the line of scrimmage.
Got to get the ball to Curtis Conley.
Third down. Sets it over the middle. Has it complete. Shoulder, and he will be tackled at the 35-yard line.
Does USC share with him?
Fourth down. They need the 41-yard line. He got it. And, whoa, this is going to be close.
This is close. Southern Cal keeps the ball.
Johnson steps up, drills it over the middle, well short. Maybe the victory, but not by those numbers. 42-23. Middle screen. They got it complete to Hannah. And he will take it shy of the 50-yard line. It's going
here just to settle him down and get a better play call.
Pumping over the middle, incomplete at the 50-yard line. And he's got the fourth highest passing game in UCLA history. Going to go on top. And he's got a man wide open, Morton. And he runs out of bounds because of the trajectory of the ball at the 13-yard line. He wanted the middle screen. Thought he was covered. He'll run it. At the 10, at the 5, and... nope, they're going to see out of bounds at the 1-foot line.
Sees the marker, the pylon, but he steps out of bounds really about the 1-yard line.
Nope, figure wrong. Straight ahead, and Strother does not get in. Strother at the 1 foot line.
Deion Strother, number 25, trying to go up top, and he reaches that ball off, out, and it came loose. Bounced right back to him.
Straight ahead, and still no signal.
I think he's in the end zone.
Still no signal. It sure looks like it. Touchdown, Trojans.
Now comes the play of the game.
Let's see if the Trojans get this one in and a portion of the title. Looks back over the middle for the tight end. Knocked down, no good. Jackson is who he wanted.
Tried to bring Yanni. There's a penalty flag on UCLA for too many people celebrating. This is Yanni Jackson trying to get across.
Watch,
and he'll
watch
run
he
into
does.
The umpire.
And exactly. That gave the DC wanted to throw, and then by the time he cleared, recovered by the Bruins. Mike Wynn.
Well, when you go to the movie theater in the year 2020, there'll probably be a movie about John Barnes and his starting assignment versus USC.
Goes down on one knee, protected by his teammates. And the celebration begins here at the Rose Bowl. They do not. With the ball firmly under his arm, John Barnes holds on, and his coach gets a ride. As the Bruins have pulled off what many thought was an impossible dream.